When I look over the land I'm blessed to own, you always get this feeling of potential. No matter how much blood, sweat, and tears is going into this place, you always see things that you can improve. But sometimes it's important to step back and think about and appreciate the things that have already been accomplished. As we celebrate National Day of the Farmer, I am honored to partner with Kubota's Gear to Give initiative to recognize five Farmer Veteran Coalition families who are keeping our country fed during this challenging time. These five men and women served our country in the military and now are serving our country, helping to place food on our tables. Two of our recipients are here with us in person, and I'll get to speak with three families via video.
My name is Joshua Nelson. I'm from Ripley, West Virginia, and I'm a regenerative rancher up in that area.
I'm Kara Rutter. I recently retired from the Army, and my husband and I own Project Victory Gardens in Aiken, South Carolina.
Back in 2017, I fly C-130s and was heading into combat and kind of watching everything that was going on the ground. The Kurds were down there farming right in the middle of all that war and everything, and it really moved me to take ranching seriously when I got home. So since 2017, we've been at it and building our farm and our ranch and running a fence line and really trying to contribute to the national food security and providing for our local community.
My husband and I are just recently retired from the Army. He was a command sergeant major and I was a sergeant major. And as we retired, we knew that we wanted to do something to help veterans. We also wanted to get out of an office. We didn't want to be the folks that retired and went right back to doing exactly what we'd been doing for the last 20 some years. So we opened up a farm. We have a 20-acre farm in Aiken, South Carolina, where our whole purpose is to get veterans involved in agriculture.
Hey everybody, welcome to Countrywide Whitetails at Promised Land Farms. I gotta tell you, man, I'm so proud of this place. A lot of blood, sweat, and tears went into it. Actually, we built it as a place for disabled vets and kids to come hunt. So everything's handicap accessible. A lot of the blinds we have out here are handicap accessible. And it's just been a wonderful place, you know, to be able to share something I love with people that deserve it. So I'm honored to have you guys and girls here. Thank y'all so much for coming. I know a little bit about what y'all are a part of. We got the huge opportunity to work with the Farmers Veterans Coalition on tour. They worked hand in hand with catering, you know, to use some of the products they were raising and providing. And anything left over went to people who were battling hunger in their communities. But today is a special day. We're here with some guys from Kubota, and they're going to introduce themselves. I'm just interested, man, what got y'all involved with, you know, FBC and what you have in store for these folks today?
Thank you, Brantley. So I'm Alex Woods, Vice President with Kubota Tractor.
I'm John Sargent, Senior Director with Kubota Tractor.
And Brantley, I'm also a member of the Board of Directors of the Farmer Veteran Coalition, and I just want to take an opportunity to say thank you for what you're doing to help us get the word out about the Farmer Veteran Coalition. This is a very special day for us. And every year, Kubota Tractor, since 2015, has been awarding to some very appropriate people, some veterans, tractors, Kubota equipment. And today we're here to recognize two people who have, as we like to say, served their country twice. Once through military service, and second time, even more importantly, by helping feed all of us Americans. So we're very privileged and proud to have you, and this is a very special day for us, and I have a couple things to present.
Amen.
So first I want to present these two certificates, and they read Kubota Tractor Corporation and the Farmer Veteran Coalition are pleased to present the certificate and a new Kubota tractor to Joshua Nelson in recognition of significant contributions to U.S. military service and support of our local community through outstanding efforts in farming. And also obviously to Kara Rutter of Project Victory Gardens. So thank you very much to both of you. Very happy day for us. In addition to that, Sarge, we also have some special coins we had. As you're familiar with being in a military condition tradition, the challenge coins. And we've had specific challenge coins minted to recognize your transition from the military ethics that you are proud and privileged to have come from in the past, and bridging that with the Farmer Veteran Coalition and your dedication to agriculture. We hope that this coin will serve as that recognition. So with that, we thank you very much. Sarge, would you hand these out, please?
Thank you so much.
But I think more importantly, Brantley, I think they want some tractors.
Let's do that.
So this, we have a symbolic key here to represent the Kubota equipment that I know Josh, we delivered his tractor last week.
Yes, sir.
And we have Kara's ready to deliver here later this week. So we're very, very excited to see how you can use this power to empower you to improve the lives of your family and your communities and all of us Americans. So thank you again so much for your service and dedication.
Coming up, we'll check in with our three other recipients, and I'll perform my new single, Hard Days. All right, folks, I get to meet our three additional Kubota Geared to Give honorees. First up, say hello to Bodie Anderson of Honamu, Hawaii, from the Western Division. Oh, and we're on. Man, hey, Bodie, how you doing, my friend?
Good, how you doing, Brantley?
Doing great, man, doing great. I hate you couldn't make it today, but
I understand you're quite a ways away in Hawaii.
Yep.
Awesome.
Yeah, I'm on the Big Island.
That's awesome.
The honor is all mine to be able to talk to you today. Congratulations, man. I tell you, I have so much respect
for you guys and girls, you know, that sacrifice so much for our country. Especially, I got a chance to read up a little bit about what you're doing and what you've done. And man, your deployments are no joke. Not that any of them are. You just look like a highly decorated hero in my book. And I got to tell you what you're doing on the farming side of things. What I love about it is it has a grassroots aspect that, man, you just don't see a lot of anymore. You know, you're taking that kind of initiative to
feed 100 families a month. Man, where did that idea come from?
From my wife, actually. Britt, are you around?
Yeah.
You want to join? Yeah, that was my wife's, that was her dream to try and feed 100 local families. We're already there, and now even going higher. So we're hoping to double that in no time.
I asked him about the, you know, feeding 100 families a month, and that's, you know, at first when I was reading it, I was like, 100 families a year, that's pretty, a month? Had to take a
double take at it. But congratulations, yeah, man, on winning this award.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate that.
Hey, man, thank y'all so much for what y'all do. I look forward to seeing you and speaking with you again soon. And congratulations a million times over.
All right, man. Y'all have a good day. See ya. She called me B. She knows what's up. See? Now let's welcome Central Division recipient Andrew Edelson from Alice, Texas.
Ah, there he is. What's going on, Andrew?
It's going great.
Awesome, man. You know, 5.5 years in the Marine Corps. You know, that's already a hero in my book. I can't imagine the things you've seen, the things you've been through, and so it's awesome to see guys like you, man, come home and get involved in something like you're involved in. And man, I'm a huge fan of family farms and handing things down. It says you're a second generation farmer, and you know, I got it handed down to you, and I'm sure you'll hand it down yourself. And man, just wanted to tell you, I think what you're doing is absolutely admirable, and it's an honor to talk to you.
My ultimate goal 20, 30 years down the road is I want to produce 80% of a single household's food intake. So I want to be able to produce 80% of what you eat.
Nice.
That's a lot.
Hey, man, you know, taking initiative to even go after a goal like that's admirable, and man, I know you'll be an inspiration to people watching this, and you've already been an inspiration to me and thousands of other folks just by sacrificing your time and putting yourself in harm's way for freedom. So, man, hats off to you. Again, it's an honor, man. I hope this month continues. I hope the rest of this year is awesome for you, brother, and hope to see you and shake your hand sometime soon.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
All right, buddy. You have a good day.
Last but not least, meet Cody Miller, our winner from Iowa, representing the Midwest Division.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you. How you doing, Cody?
Good. How are you doing?
Oh, man, I'm doing awesome. Man, congratulations on being awarded. Man, you definitely deserve it. I've had a chance to look at some information about you here, man. You seem like an amazing guy. And again, it's an honor to talk to you today.
Well, thank you. You as well. I really appreciate any artist's work.
Well, thank you, buddy. You know, you're moving forward and you've taken incentive and initiative and you know, helping vets, you know, like yourself and first responders as well. Just on coping with PTSD, which is, you know, another thing that I think it's amazing that, you know, for anybody, you know, to raise awareness for, let alone someone like yourself with deployments that has experience and you know, knows where folks are coming from. So, man, thank you for taking the time to hang with me today for a minute.
No problem. Well, thank you for your time as well. Yeah, it's been a long road and quite, oh, we could almost call it the typical up and down story. And then I'm just glad everything's on the uphill slide.
I hear you, buddy. I can't imagine, you know, the sacrifice that you guys put out there on the line is nothing short of admirable. And nobody knows better than you guys and girls what will actually help and what actually makes a difference. And that's something that's been extremely beneficial to me in my career. In being able to raise awareness or help in any way, form or fashion, is to actually talk to vets and see what it is they need. I think it's absolutely admirable. You're already a hero, and I can't imagine having to leave when you did, you know, in 2009 and 10, you know, this country was going through a hell of a time. I can't imagine what it was like to uproot, especially from a family farm, knowing how much work goes into that to go serve your country. And that's a massive sacrifice in itself. So, man, thank you so much for your service. Thank you so much for your time here today.
I really appreciate everything you're doing in partnership with Kubota and Farmer Veteran Coalition. Because, like you said, that earthwork, I call it earthwork, working with your hands and animals, just provides a deep sense of purpose and in a sense, camaraderie. It just ties you to something that, you know, when I put on my shirt in the morning, it's almost like putting on my uniform. I got something to go out and do and take care of my son and family. And that really did a whole lot for me. And so I hope to help spread that message to others.
You'll be in my thoughts and prayers from this moment forward. And congratulations again, man. And I look forward to meeting you in person, buddy.
Sounds great.
All right, man. Have a nice day.
We've given out all the Kubota tractors, eaten all the food, and taken in the beauty of the land. I guess the only thing left is for me to do what I do best, sing. I'm going to leave you with a performance of my new single, Hard Days. I don't need to tell you how challenging these times are, but I do hope today's special event reminded us all how persistence and dedication can change the course of our lives, regardless of our circumstances. Thanks, everybody. Stay safe. And a special thank you to our veteran farmers on National Day of the Farmer. You will never learn the words to Amazing Grace. Never felt the chill of a pew when you lost faith. Blood, sweat, and tears wouldn't mean a thing if you didn't strike out a couple hundred times. Never put your fist in the air, didn't cuss the sky. You would have never known to ask the good Lord why, or if it changed your life. If you never had a hard day, never had a heartbreak, nothing more than you.
carried away. A life on your shoulders, you feel like you earned it. Would you live with a purpose, living on your own strength? If you never had a day, you wouldn't know what it's like to dance in the rain. Never see the silver lining when the skies go gray. Wouldn't know a dream come true from the few that don't. You never find your way on a broken road. You never had a hard day. If you never had a hard day, never had more than you can take. Carried away, alive on your shoulders. Carried away, alive on your shoulders.